Hi, everyone, and welcome to a brand new lesson. As the owner of my company, Stealthy Wood, I juggle many responsibilities, and approving purchases is one of them. As Stealthy Wood grows, manual processes like recording everything on paper or in Excel are too slow. They reduce our ability to work efficiently. So automating tasks with the purchase app will help us greatly as everything is done in just a few clicks. The implementation of a purchasing policy will also help us create budgets and keep an eye on our cash flow. And as we will keep track of everything, we'll be able to do our reports on time and with accuracy. Great, isn't it? But we won't be the only ones to benefit from this. Our suppliers will also see the advantage, giving them the possibility to deliver and track products easily. Doing so, they will verify our orders and assemble our goods quickly, making us save time and keep operations running efficiently. So let's see how we can make this happen in our Stealthy Wood database. All right, here I am on my database. So let's go ahead and see how we can create a purchase order from the purchase app. So we're gonna go straight to purchase. And here we're going to see right away all of our requests for quotations, also known as RFQs, and purchase orders, also known as POs. So let's create a new one simply by clicking on the Create button right here. All right, so when we create a new request for quotation, the first thing we're going to want to do is add our vendor. Okay, we need to decide who we want to purchase some products from. So I'm going to choose my vendor as your interior. Okay, and then after we've added the vendor, we also need to decide what products we want to buy from them. And I'm going to specify those right down below under the product section. So let's go ahead and add a product. In this case, I'm going to choose my pedal bin. Now, by default, the quantity that we purchase will be one, and we're going to modify this. I'm going to say 20. I do want to purchase more than just one of this item, and I'm also going to change the unit price as well. So maybe I've seen their catalog. I know how much this item costs, so I'm going to put 15. Okay, so this looks good so far. Of course, we can modify the other things in this line as well, such as the taxes, but I'm not going to do that. Okay, so once we have created our basic request for quotation, we will save it, and then we can either print it or we can send it by email to the vendor, which is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to click on send by email. Okay, I will have my email template pop up, which I can modify right away, or I can just go ahead and send it the way that it is. I think this looks pretty good, so I'm going to click on send. Okay, once I click on send, I'm going to see a status change from RFQ to RFQ sent. And in the chatter of the document, I'm going to see the body of the email as well as the RFQ PDF attachment. All right, so I'll be able to check that out as well. Okay, so let's say we sent it to the vendor, they agreed to sell us these items. The next logical step is to confirm the request for quotation, and Odoo will suggest that. So let's click on confirm order. All right, once we click on confirm order, we're going to see a status change again from RFQ sent to purchase order, and then a receipt will be created, which we see in the corner right here. But we're going to be able to receive the products simply by clicking on the button Receive Products. So let's click here. All right, we're going to be redirected to the receipt, which we can validate. So of course, we can click on Edit and change the done quantity. We asked for 20 items, and we can see how many items we actually received. So I can put 20 here. If I don't add anything and I click on Validate, Odoo will automatically apply the demand quantity as the done quantity. So let's do that. Let's click on Apply. All right, and we see the status change from ready to done at the top as well. So you can always keep track of the status by looking at the status bar here. All right, let's go back to our purchase order. We always can access the receipt. It's good to go here. And this is just the basics for creating a purchase order. But of course, there are some other things that we can do between the request for quotation and when we actually receive the product, such as quality checks. But we're going to talk about that in another video. There are some additional things I want to show you in this video, though. One thing I do want to do for sure is to add some additional security measures. One of which is I want to be able to approve the purchase orders my users are creating if they are above a certain amount. Okay, so I'm actually going to go to configuration settings while I'm here on the purchase application. And I'm going to activate the option purchase order approval. I've already activated it actually. And then I'm going to add a minimum amount. Okay, so I want to say if my users create a purchase order that is above $250, I need to approve it before it can be confirmed. Okay, so we're going to look at that, and we're also going to be sure we have warnings activated. This will work for products or vendors, and I'm going to show you what that looks like as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and log out and log in as one of my users since I already have these features saved. So I'm going to log out, and I'm going to log in as my user Eduardo. Okay. And I'm going to go to the purchase application and create a new request for quotation. So let's go ahead and choose Azure Interior again. And actually, I'm going to go ahead and show you that what that warning option does that we saved from the settings. So let's go ahead and go to our vendor contact template here, and we're going to jump over to the internal notes tab. And since I have that activated, I'm going to see warning on the purchase order. Okay, so I can click warning. Right now, by default, it will be no message, but I can click on warning. I've already added a warning, no delivery after 5 p.m. on weekends. I can say, I can edit it right here. I can just say no delivery on weekends at all. So let's do that now. And then we're going to save. And when I add that vendor, whenever I add that vendor to a purchase order, I'm going to get this pop-up warning for Azure Interior, no delivery on weekends at all. And this will be for all of my users. Whenever they add this vendor, they're going to get this pop-up, which is always good to keep in mind for future planning. Okay, so let me just remove Azure Interior again, re-add them. I get the pop-up. It's as simple as that, but it's extremely useful. So let's click on OK. Then we're going to go ahead and add our product. So I'm going to add that pedal bin. Now you're going to notice something here. The unit price is actually the same as the unit price that I added the last time. So since I was purchasing this product for the first time from this vendor, it remembered the price that I purchased this product for. And we can actually modify that on the product template. So if we go to the purchase tab, we see that the vendor was automatically added as well as the price. We can modify here if we would like to. So the next time we create a purchase order for this product and vendor combination, it will automatically apply the correct price. So that's really cool. So let's go ahead and save this. All right, and I'm going to purchase 20 of this item, of course, and we do see that the total is above $250. So we are going to need the manager approval, but let's see what that looks like. I'm going to save this. So far, it looks like just a regular request for quotation, but when I click on confirm order, we're going to see that there is a new status here to approve. Okay, so it doesn't go directly to the purchase order, and that's for the manager. All right, again, we'll be able to see the history of this in the chatter. So RFQ to approve. So now that we see that it works, let's log out and let's log back in as the administrator. Okay, so I'm going to log in as myself. And then I'm going to go back to the purchase application, and I'm going to look at that request for quotation that my user created. So first of all, I already see that the status is to approve. So let's click here. And then I'm going to have the button approve order. Since I'm an administrator for the purchase application, I have the power to approve this order. So let's go ahead and click on approve order. Then we'll be moved to purchase order and we'll be able to receive the products. So let's go ahead and complete the flow. So I'm going to receive the products. This time I'm actually going to say that I didn't receive all of the products, that actually they only sent me 15. All right, so I'm going to save and validate. And when I try to validate this, Odoo, of course, will recognize that it's not the full amount that I ordered. So it will ask me if I want to create a back order saying that I still want to receive these products at some point, or if I don't want a back order at all. If I say, okay, I wanted 20, they only had 15 available, I'll take the 15. I don't care about the rest. I don't want to receive them later. I'm just good with what I have. I don't have to create a back order. So I'm going to click on no back order. Okay, so I just have 15 done here. All right, and then when we go back to the purchase order, we will then be able to create a bill. We need to pay our vendors. Okay, so let's click on create bill. Now, when I do that, I'm gonna see that the quantity has reflects what we actually received. Okay, so even though I ordered 20, I received 15, and I will only have to pay for 15. So Odoo recognizes that, which is really nice. So let's post this, and then we'll register the payment, validate. Okay, we see that it's marked as paid. We'll go back to the purchase order, and we do have the full history of events here. I see that I ordered 20, I received 15, and I was billed for 15. Okay, so I have all of that right here. And on the receipt, I'm gonna see that we had a demand for 15, 15 were done, but we also asked for 5 in addition. So originally we asked for 20, but 5 were not done. Okay, so we can see everything that's going on here as well. All right, so that's the basics of the purchase application, but there are so many more things to see, so be sure you check out the rest of the videos. That's all for this one, but if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.